Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. You know how when you go to a state fair or a county fair and they have the commercial building and you think, well, you're going to just flip right on through there really fast and then you get caught up finding all sorts of interesting things? That's what happened to us at state fair. We went in thinking we were just going to look for the people with the hand clippers and ended up finding the neatest things. And one of them was a plumeria. It's from Hawaii. It is a tropical plant and it blossoms these beautiful flowers. And this is how you buy them. They're just pieces of branches that have been cut off and they sit out for a couple of weeks and then they're ready to plant again. And because we live in a non-tropical situation here in Wisconsin, they will go dormant during the summer, during the winter, excuse me, and then they'll flower out in the summer. So we're going to plant them today. When we bought them, we got a pot with them, and then all we need to do is add the soil. So they say, put the soil in, a nice mix of potting soil that will drain well. So I have some vermiculite in there, use perlite. 2 inches on the bottom underneath, and then just fill it up.
So these are called Hawaiian
Plumeria.
Plumeria. Okay. And I think you got 3 different colors too, didn't you?
Yes, we did. Well, I know we got a red one. And then we have
either a yellow
and pink one. I think for sure we have a pink, and then I don't know if the other one was white or yellow. Or a mix. They were some kind of mix.
So I'm sure we'll find out soon.
We will. So you don't want to put them, fill it all the way up because you want to be able to water it without the soil flying out of there. And the interesting thing about these is they like to totally dry out in between waterings. So after I water it today, I don't water it again for 2 weeks. It likes to be totally dry before you water again. And then in the winter, they warn you ahead of time that if you have them in the house, the leaves will fall off and they'll go dormant. And then you only water them 1 time a month until the spring. So
you might think that they're actually dead because the leaves are coming off?
True, yes.
But they're really just dormant?
They're dormant, yes. So here we go. It says water it until the water drains out at the bottom. See how that goes. Now we didn't know if it would stay standing upright by itself because it does seem to be.
That's a very sturdy stock.
Yes, it is.
You know, and it kind of surprised me that it didn't. I know why it has to have a couple of inches underneath, but the pot seemed rather shallow to me.
See, that obviously is not enough because I didn't get any coming onto the bottom. Obviously, be careful if you're doing this, if you ever find one of these, because it will drain out the bottom. Also, they said as it gets older, you can trim off your own branches and start new ones, but that the sap itself is kind of harmful. If you get it on your skin and you start having reactions, they said call the poison line. So don't get the sap on yourself. But that could go for other things too, like milkweeds and all sorts of things that have sap in them.
So you shouldn't kiss your plant.
Do not. No. At least not the sappy part. Okay, that one's done. You're done for 2 weeks.
Okay, on to number two and number three.
Yep. Here we go. be a nice gift to give someone once you get your plant growing and you can chop off some branches. You could share with everybody. A little off to the side.
But there's such a pretty young lady who was manning that particular booth too.
And she was from Wisconsin.
Yep.
And these plants themselves are from Hawaii, correct?
Correct.
Isn't that what we understood?
Yep.
Pretty simple to plant. Okay, do your thing, Hawaiian plants. Now obviously in Hawaii these grow outside. If you are in a place where it doesn't get below 40 degrees at night, they can stay outside all the time. And then they just get watered by the rain. So, we'll see you. We'll let you know how they turn out. Look for us again. Bye-bye.
So, where are these going now?
On the porch, I think.
Yep. Should be nice and warm for them out there.
Mm-hmm.
At least for another month or two.
Yep. And in every year we try to plant something unique and different just for the fun of it. One year it was peanuts. This year it was cotton. We found seeds for a cotton plant and we thought it would be interesting for our grandson to see how cotton grows. So we planted the seeds in the pot and only one of them grew, but this one has now developed flowers. So we will be able to see up here in the Northland what cotton looks like, and it's really neat how the flowers come out of three leaves that are kind of praying together there, and out of that comes,
it's like a triangle.
Mm-hmm. Out of that comes the flower, and then obviously that's where the ball of cotton will be.
Are you going to start spinning your own fabrics?
No, I don't think so.
So we're now, is this an annual or?
Up here it is, yes.
Okay.
I don't know if it is where it grows naturally or if you have to plant the plant every year. I don't know. That's a good question. But up here in the Northland, it would be. So this is a one-time thing.
Well, I'm sure it'll drop its seeds too if you allow it.
Yes. And it, I'm sure, has loved this drought. Very, very hot summer that we've had. We just kept it watered in the pot, and it's doing great.
That's got to be at least 2.5 feet.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how tall the major cotton plants.
Well, I don't know. When you see pictures of people
picking cotton,
they're, you know, like this tall, I think. So a little bit taller, perhaps bushier.
I often wonder what that meant to. Keep your cotton picking hands off my stuff.
Indeed. Well, my fans are calling me. Hello? Hi.
See what happens when we're in the midst of producing videos? It's amazing when you have thousands of people following you every day. Anyhow, there's our cotton plant, so we'll see what happens this year. So. Lynn says, bye-bye, we'll see you next time.
Yeah.
Thanks for your thumbs up.